give all praise, honor, and glory to the Most High God, Yahweh. In the name of his only begotten Son, Yahweh, Shah, who the world quickly exposes. So who are we? We're the Hebrew Israelites, right? The black Hebrew Israelites, the menaces to society, the ones that are with this racist and hate everybody, just full of hate. But actually, we're full of love. Are we here to show love to the people that's been showed hate for 500 years? We're out here to actually show love to the people that need the love. Some people don't even need it. They can get it in 2 months. Right? So let me get John 3:16. Let's go over it. We're going to open it with John 3:16. Because at the end of the day, that is a scripture that our Messiah gave out. That is a scripture our Messiah gave out. John 3:16. Let's read it. It's the book of John, chapter 3, verse 16. For God so loved the world. See, God so loved the world, right? When you go into the Greek word for world, it means cosmos, which means a government or a nation of people. So who is that world that God is talking about? He's talking about the Israelites, the Jews, right, Reed? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. But it's so interesting that the main people in the world that are perishing right now, the main people that are in agony right now, need Christ. And that's not everybody. Everybody's not in trial and tribulation these days. I mean, Revelation 2 and 9. Everybody's not in trial and tribulations these days. Everybody's not perishing. There's only a specific people that need this everlasting life because all their life they have had nothing but death. And that's the Black and Hispanic and Native American, the Moreno, Latino, and Nativo, and Israelita, according to the Bible. Now, let me get Wisdom of Solomon 1 and 12.
On the book of Revelation, chapter 2, verse 9. I know thy works and tribulation.
I know thy what?
I know thy works and tribulation.
See, God knows the works and tribulation of the Black and Hispanic man, women, and children. He knows the tribulation we go through. He knows the oppression. He knows the oppression that Blacks and Hispanics go through. He knows the ops he's looking for. He knows all of that. We got enemies out here, man. He knows we're in poverty, right? We're in poverty. He knows that a life bill gotta be paid. He knows we don't got the rent all the way there. He knows we don't get wages that stay. We get wages that we put in the back of the home. Right, go ahead. Spanish, Morenos, Latinos, we are very rich. How are we rich? In spirit. It's so crazy how you have the tribe of Issachar and various other northern kingdom tribes, the Mexicans, and they can come together on the day of the dead and make it look good. Ain't nobody in the world can make bad things look good like Blacks and Hispanics. That's how you know. That's how you know that these kids, they're just so special. Mexican, just know he's special, man. Just know that Mexicans, Dominicans, Puerto Ricans, they're our people as well. Because this is not only a black, right? But there's something out there. We got to tell our brothers and sisters over here, man. Manos and Manos, too. Amigos, we got to let you know that God is not dealing with the day of the dead. The Most High is not dealing with the day of the dead. Why? Why are you going to celebrate his death? And the real day of the dead is Thanksgiving, because that's the death of my ancestors. Man, bring me some. One and 12. For the wisdom of Solomon to the one and 12. Seek not death in the era of your life.
It said what?
Seek not death.
It says seek not death. But constantly you are Black and Hispanic seeking death. We're always making threats, trying to put our life on the line for things that don't even matter.
Man, a wise man, a rapper by the name of FBG Duck said, Black people are not each other's problem. We made each other's problem. And that's such a profound quote by the late great FDG Duck, rapper of Chicago, man. Because he's letting you know that black people, we're not each other's problem, but we constantly make each other's problem. And Hispanics as well. A nigga step on your Balenciaga, a nigga step on your Jordan, a nigga wanna steal from another brother. Right? You just made him your problem. We're making each other's problem. It's so sad, right? That the Mexicanos, the golden kingdom of Israel, the Israelitas, the Judíos, they were out here and they built America. But now they got a second job, they got to dress up in costumes, they got to work the hardest job just to make a living. But you built America, you should be on top. You're the princes, we're the kings. What's going on, my sister? Oh, my God,
I'm just looking right there. You boast that you made a treaty with death.
Oh yeah, I'm a demon. I'm on demon time. You boast with this man. They always saying something crazy. I'm crazy. Everybody wants to be the next craziest person. The next deadly person, right?
You boast that you have made a treaty with death and reached an agreement with the world of the dead.
You made an agreement with the world of the dead. What's going on, my bro? What's that question, my bro? Mexicano, come on, come on. Okay.
You have made a treaty with death and an agreement with the world of the dead.
Crean, you
believe in God, right?
So, how do you think God feels about the day of the dead?
What'd you say?
How does he feel? Like, how do you think God feels about his chosen people, Mexicanos, celebrating the day of the dead? Give me Isaiah 1 and 3. And this is something we have to think. We have to think about the motherfuckers inside of God.